Hello, good evening, and welcome to our online prayer meeting today. I want to thank you very much for taking our time to join the prayer meeting today. I believe, God, that the Holy Spirit will help us to pray effectively today in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Today we are going to be taking a special prayer. You know, I saw something in the scripture, and I want us to spend time in the presence of God to pray over what I saw in the Word of God today. I want us to start by, I think I've got the scripture on the screen. Do we have people joining us via the Zoom platform?
Yes.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you for joining. And for all our viewers that are joined via Facebook, I want to thank you for joining too. I want us to start by looking at two scriptures. I want us to look at the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 34. I'm going to put it on the screen for those of us watching via Facebook so we can see it. It's already on the screen. 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 34. It reads, "Awake to righteousness and sin not, for some have not the knowledge of God. I speak this to your shame." I mean, when I came across that scripture, I'm like, seriously? You mean Brother Paul can write something like this? He said, "Awake to righteousness and sin not, for some have not the knowledge of God." Some people don't have the knowledge of God. And as I was thinking about this, I mean, of course, the Holy Spirit led me to this scripture. And as I was thinking about this scripture, the Holy Ghost told me, he said, "Do you know what?" I said, "What?" He said, "Many people know the voice of men of God, especially the prominent one, that they know my voice." I mean, it was at that point I'm like, wow. He said, "If I call the name of some men of God, if they are preaching right now, you are listening to their messages, say you know their voice." He says, "Some of you can even repeat what they preached or what they say verbatim." Said, "To the extent that, you know, I have many of my children who are sounding like my servant, but they don't know my voice." So you and I will see that is an important prayer point for us to take today. And then the Lord began to open my eyes to see different scriptures. Scriptures that I have read before, I begin to see the knowledge of God, or the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ, personal revelation of Him, being tied to so many things in the scripture. So, for example, when you read 2 Peter chapter 1, we will not have time to look at it. It says, "Grace and peace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and of our Lord Jesus Christ." The church will become perfected. You know, the reason God plays the fivefold ministry, you know, in His body, in Ephesians chapter 4, is so that we might come to the knowledge of the Son of God, so that we might come to the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. So that means this is an important prayer point for us to take. Of course, one way of doing it is for us to go to Ephesians chapter 1, and then for us to take that prayer there. But I believe God just wants us to spend time using Exodus chapter 33. And I want you to just think, I'm still laying the foundation and we're going to go into prayer and we will take the prayer point. I'm not going to stop us. We're just going to pray. Exodus 33, let's think about what Moses did. Think about all the miracles in the land of Egypt. Think about him just stretching forth rod and Red Sea just parting and people passing right through. You know, on a dry land. And the only thing this guy could ask God for, the only thing, can you imagine Exodus chapter 33, verses 13 and 16? He said, "Now therefore, I pray thee, if I have found grace in your sight, show, if I have found grace in your in thy sight, show me now your way, that I may know you, that I may find grace in your sight. In other words, when you have a personal revelation of our Lord Jesus Christ, when you grow in the knowledge of God, and this is what he said, you know, after that, he said, and the Lord told him, say, my presence shall go with you. And he said, for wherein shall it be known here that I and thy people have found grace in your sight? Is it not in that thou goest with us? So shall we be separated or distinguished. And I know a lot of people, when they read that, they normally focus on the bit that says, God's presence going with us, and we pray in church, we do praise and worship, we say we bring down his presence. But I found something more powerful, and that thing is for you to come into a personal revelation of our Lord Jesus Christ. Ah, oh my God, I saw something in the scripture today. I'm like, wow, wow, wow. So what we're going to be doing today is we're going to be spending time. You know, when you read 1 Corinthians, when you read 1 Corinthians chapter 15, Paul was giving an account of his own experience, and he told us of how when Jesus Christ, you know, rose from the dead, he started appearing to people, appeared to the disciple, appeared to about 500 people at once, and then he came to me, to himself, and I say, and lastly, he also appear unto me. Well, I would love it if the Lord will appear to me and reveal himself to me, but that's not my goal. My goal right now is I want to know him. And that's what we're going to pray for today. We're going to be asking him, say, Lord, show us your way that we may know you. You know, like that scripture says, I awake to righteousness and sin not. For some have not the knowledge of God. We don't want to be people who don't have the knowledge of God. We want to be people who are filled with the knowledge of the Most High. So I want us to come before God right now. I want us to begin to pray. I've put the prayer point on the screen. The reason I've done that is because I want us to spend time to pray. So you are going to be asking your God, Lord, I ask you to guide me clearly along the way you want me to travel, in the name of Jesus. Lord Jesus, guide me clearly along the way you want me to travel. Lord, you know everything. You know everything on the way. Lord, you know the plan that they've got in my office. You know what is right there in the year 2019. You know the way ahead to the end of this year. Things that I don't know, you know. So, Lord, I am praying, I'm asking you for divine guidance in the name of Jesus. Let's lift up our voice and begin to pray to God. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you today, and we are asking in Jesus' name, that Lord, that you will guide us along the way you want us to travel. Lord, show us your way in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we pray, we ask you today in the mighty name of Jesus that you will show us your ways. Lord, reveal yourself to us in the mighty name of Jesus. Guide us, Lord Jesus, in the way that you want us to travel, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, that's what we are asking you for. We want to know you. Lord, we want to be people who know you, who recognize you, Lord, who are able to recognize you, recognize your voice. Lord, that's what we are asking for today in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, help us to know you, Lord. Help us to know you, Lord. Show us your way, 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 Lord. Show us the way you want us to travel in this life. Lord, show us the way. Show us the way, Lord. Show us the way, Lord, the way you want us to travel. Lord, we don't want to be people who are beating about the bush. That's what we are asking for today. We are asking you in the name of Jesus, Lord, that you will reveal your plan, you reveal your purpose to us, Lord. Show us the reason why you created us. Lord, show us the way you want us to travel in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we ask you to show us your way. Show us your way, Lord. Show us your way, Lord, the way you want us to travel, Lord. Show us your way, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, we ask you today that you will reveal your mind. You reveal your counsel, Lord. Lord, Proverbs chapter 19, 21 says, there are many plans in the heart of a man, but the counsel of the Lord shall stand. It is only the things that the Lord has decided that will come to pass. Lord, we do not want to engage in businesses that you are not interested in. Lord, we don't want to find ourselves in relationships that we know you are not interested in. Lord, we don't want to go and work for an organization, Lord, where your presence will not go with us. Lord, we don't want to engage in businesses. Lord, we don't want to do things that we know that you have not approved of, things that you have not decided, things that, Lord, you have not proposed. So that's why we are crying unto you today, Lord. We are asking you in the name of Jesus, the Lord, you will show us your way. You will show us your mind in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we want to know you on a personal level. We want to know you. We want to become acquainted with you. Lord, we want to be able to perceive your presence. Lord, we want to be able to recognize your voice. Lord, we want to be able to understand the way you walk, the way you do your things in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we come before you today. We ask in the name of Jesus that you will help us understand you, to walk acceptably before you, Lord. Lord, help us know things that are written in the scriptures, why they are written in the scripture. Lord, we are asking for revelation. Lord, we are asking that you will open our eyes, Lord. We are asking today, Holy Spirit, we ask you that you begin to tell us why certain things are written in the word of the Lord. You will open our eyes, particularly, Lord, to things that our Lord Jesus Christ wanted to tell the disciples that they were not able to bear. Holy Spirit, our Lord Jesus said, when you come, you will reveal things to us. You will tell us the thing that our Lord Jesus Christ wanted to tell the disciples that they were not able to bear it then. That's what the word of the Lord says. So, Lord, we come before you today in the name of Jesus. That, Lord, that you will reveal yourself to us in our dreams, Lord. Reveal yourself to us on our way to walk. Reveal your mind to us. Lord, as we go about our daily business, Lord, we ask you that you will reveal your mind, you will reveal your counsel, your purpose to us in the name of Jesus. Lord, help us to know you. Help us to understand you. Help us to walk acceptably before you in the name of Jesus. Lord, we ask you that you will let us in on your plans, Lord. In the name of Jesus. In that way, we will become special to you. Because, Lord, when things are not hidden to us, Lord, you said we should ask us and you will show us things that are fenced in, things that are hidden from us. That's what you say. He said, you will show us great and mighty things. So, Lord, we ask you today in the name of Jesus that you will show us great and mighty things. In Jesus' name, Lord, we ask, Lord, that Lord, you will show us great and mighty things. Lord, we pray, oh Lord, that this divine nature will be a reality in our lives, will be something we experience on a daily basis, Lord. We pray that you will open our eyes to see things that are available in the realm of the Spirit. Lord, you will open our ears to hear the things, the voice of the Spirit. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we pray in Jesus' name that you will walk on our minds, Lord. You will walk on our heart, Lord, to perceive the things of the Spirit. In the mighty name of Jesus, we ask you today, Lord, that you will show us your way. Lord, show us your way, Lord, so that we may know you, become more deeply and intimately acquainted with you, perceiving and recognizing and understanding you more strongly and clearly. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we come before you today. We ask you that you will help us. Lord, we ask you that you will help us to know you. Lord, Apostle Paul said there is one thing that he desires, And he said that he is ready, he's willing to abandon everything for that. And he said, and that is to know you. That is to know you and to experience the power of your resurrection. Lord, there are people in our life that we know them more than we know you. But Lord, we are asking you today, we are saying in the name of Jesus, that we know you more than we know our parents. We know you more than we know our spouses. We know you more than we know our children. Lord, we become acquainted with your way. Lord, in Jesus' name. Lord, when you are about to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah, Lord, you said concerning Abraham, he said, shall I hide a thing from Abraham, knowing that he shall become a great man? Lord, you have called us into your greatness. We have found favor in your sight. That's why you sent your only begotten son to die for our sin. Lord, if you didn't hide anything for Abraham, so, Lord, we are asking you, say, shall I not tell him what I want to do? So, Lord, we are asking you today, in the name of Jesus, that you will open our ears to see what you want us to hear, what you want us to hear. Open our eyes to see what you want us to see. Begin to let us in on your plan, Lord. Begin to let us in on your plan, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, if you told Abraham what you are about to do to a nation, the judgment that is going to come upon that nation, Lord, we ask you today, in the mighty name of Jesus, that you will do this same thing in our lives, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, you will reveal your plan. You will reveal your purpose, Lord. You help us to come into an understanding of who you are, in the name of Jesus. Lord, you will wake up us in the morning to reveal your plan to us. Lord, you will wake us up in the morning to reveal your plan to us. Lord, at night while we are lay on your bed, Lord, our minds will be filled with your thoughts. In the mighty name of Jesus, our heart will be filled with the knowledge of you. In Jesus' name, Lord, we ask you that we will be able to perceive your presence. We will know it, Lord. Lord, we read an account in the Bible where the disciples, where they were fishing, and the Lord Jesus appeared to them. Even Peter couldn't recognize him. It took John to say, it is the Lord. Lord, we pray in the name of Jesus today that we don't want to be like Jacob. Lord, we don't want to be like Jacob, Lord, that was at the gate of heaven. He saw the angel of God. He saw the ladder to heaven, the angels of God ascending and descending. And after that encounter, he said to himself, he said, the Lord was in this place and I knew it not. Lord, oh my God, we ask you today, we don't want you to be in a place and where will we find out that you were not there. Lord, the aftermath of that experience was that Jacob struggled. He struggled. He got what he could have gotten easily. He spent 21 years. Lord, we do not want to spend 21 years on things that we will get within 1 year. That's why we are asking you today. Lord, we are praying today that, Lord, the most important thing in our life is to know you. We want to come into a personal revelation of you. We want you to reveal yourself to us. Lord, the disciples were following you. Lord, you asked them, who do men really think I am? And they begin to say all sorts of things. And then you ask them the same question, who do you think I am? And some of them, they were talking about who other people told them about who God is, who Jesus is. It was Peter, by the help of the Holy Spirit. Through revelation, they said, thou art Christ, the Son of the living God. And Lord, you said, upon this revelation, you will build your church. In other words, it's only when we know you, when we come into the knowledge of you, that's when your grace, that's when your peace will be multiply on you. Lord, we know it's important. We have searched your word. We've been through your word. We have seen the importance of coming to the knowledge of you. Lord, you say you came so that we might have eternal life. John chapter 17 verse 3 say, and this is eternal life, that they may know you. Oh, Lord, we know we were not saved so that we should just go to church. We know we were not saved so that we can pay tithe and offering. We know we were not saved so that we can experience miracles. Lord, people who are not born again, they get miracles. They get miracles from you, Lord. But Lord, we want to move up the ladder, Lord. We want to know you. Lord, your word says that the children of Israel, they know your act. They knew your act, but Moses knew your way. Lord, we are asking you today in the name of Jesus that we are not people who are satisfied with your acts. We are not satisfied with your goodness. We are not satisfied with your blessing. We want to know you. We want to know your way. We want to know how you do things. We want you to let us in on your plan. We want you to reveal your mind to us. We want you to reveal your purpose to us. Lord, we want you to send us on an errand. Lord, we want you to direct us. We want you to instruct us, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we want you to guide us clearly in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray to you. This is our heart cry today. Lord, that we will hear a voice behind us telling us, this is the way, walk ye in it. Lord, we declare today in the name of Jesus that our spiritual ears are open to hear the words of the Spirit. In the name of Jesus, Lord, your word says that you raised us up together with our Lord Jesus Christ, and you made us to sit with him in heavenly places. Lord, if we are seated with our Lord Jesus Christ in the heavenly places, then we have to participate in spiritual transaction. We cannot live an ordinary life. We refuse to live an ordinary life. Your word says that we were given great and exceeding precious promises so that we might be partakers of the divine nature. Lord, we desire today, we want to be partaker. We want to walk in the divine nature. We want the divine nature. We want it to be more. We want to experience it more in our life. We want to dwell more in that realm, Lord. We want to, Lord, we want to know. We want to participate in spiritual transaction, Lord. Lord, if Apostle Paul say, and you appear to him. Lord, if you appear to us, that's fine. But one thing we know, we can ask you for, one thing we know that we can pray to you for is that we can ask you for knowledge of you, to know you, to become acquainted with you, to perceive you, Lord. Lord, to be more clear, Lord, in terms of us understanding what you want for us. What you want us to do. How you want us to do it. Lord, that's what we are asking for today. In the name of Jesus. That we will understand you, Lord, more strongly and clearly. We will understand you, Lord, more strongly and clearly. Lord, when we know that we know. That when we come into the knowledge of you, when you show us your way, when you show us your plan, Lord, things that trouble us, things that worry us, will no longer worry us. Things that trouble us, our mind will be at peace. But because we know that you will not deny us of anything, so Lord, we wait on you, Lord. We wait on you, Lord. We wait like Habakkuk waited. Habakkuk said that I will wait on my watchtower. I will wait to see what the Lord will have to say to me. So, Lord, we wait on you today. We wait, Lord. We wait to see what you have to say to us. Lord, we wait to see what you have to say to us. Our ears are open, Lord. Our eyes are open, Lord. In the name of Jesus. So brele kesinkra sukla elene bosontaya. Imaleki sukra ikelele kushta iga asonte kra solelaba. Ralia lokoko zimbra neantukubu. Rashtalia la kakasokodia. Inene mongroba kalelele kesiga laseke raposhto kalela kasodia. Lord, we refuse to live ordinary life, Lord. Reveal your mind to us. Reveal your mind to us, Lord. Reveal your mind to us, Lord. Reveal your mind to us, Lord. Help us to come into the knowledge of you, to become more acquainted with you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Rantikela koso kaba igla eseke de mashon tekele ya la koson tede de ya. Emunku subre histikla ustu kubra astekla eke simba liam choko ishtakiala la jaria loko kase mangra singla eka loko so de galaya. Lord, you appear to Peter. You told him, do not call that which I have made clean unclean. Aliengo sokela agasokera tangrai sokeria. Lord, show us things, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Umbrangela igetu koba ashtaya gasungele. Agasontele ya la kakasokelea. Rakele la 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 kokolea. Lingro bakasontele ale gasonte krante kelea. Arobushtokela ekasokala ashtonkelelea. Lord, show us things that you have approved that we are condemning. Ereke sekere sekere ke sekere ke sekere ke sekere ke sekere. Lord, show us things that you have approved that we have condemned, Lord. Ende brokese kala ikere ke sente uramba shtedea. Mangre kusokela egla sokere. Ineboko rekla astonteria. Lentu kabo rashtengle kusopra ikelele ke simpro ba ya bo. Romenene ke singra tokelele boko ke zembra kelele boso kalia la kosonteria. Lente ke keze kelele boko tokelele boso kede ya po krashta nidea. Rabo kalele ke zempo kale anta kalo kosompra ke rale lo kosonte ikrash sokelele ke zembo robo shante lele ya po kotokidea. Roboko sumbrenene koro baba 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 sonkrado kanala laba rama koro boshe ekereke sungro kale ekereke sikere poposte ngende nglanto kobore kalo kose kla ajopra kela la 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 raba baba baba soke kede ya kora kasoke de aroko sonte kereke seke ralo boko sokere ya kora poste ntere kereke seke de ya mare keke kese koropash tokelele kese rato keke ke sunte de debu runene mo koroba baba baba soko de Nebuso koprate kele busontelele rato keke simbo chingla eleke sobo kalela igere shtokelea jama koko koraka sokelele kese kele bo kamanto kelea ramanto kolobo jigre kese kele ya po kasten kelele ya po rabo kalele keso kale ya chakato kusumbra kese kele ya E mangra soke bora sekele ya koko wora kasokele la kasontelele ya Lord, we give you praise, Lord. We give you praise, Lord. Tombre ke sate ke la e la kosokedea. Rante ke lele ke zeke bo sopre ke la shte kedea tokotokra santelelea. Lord, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We give you praise, Lord. We give you praise, Lord. We give you praise, Lord. We honor you, Lord Jesus. Glory be to your name. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We praise you, Jesus. We praise you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. We praise you. Glory, glory be to your name. In the name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Now, the Lord gave us a word in Acts of Apostles chapter 10. And we're going to spend the next 1 minute or thereabout to pray concerning that word. The Lord appeared to Peter and said, a voice came to him, get up, Peter, kill and eat. But Peter said, not at all, Lord, for I have never eaten anything that is common, unholy, ceremonially unclean. And the voice came to him a second time, what God has cleansed and pronounced clean, no longer consider common or unholy. So now we are going to pray, because I sense that there are places that the Lord will want us to visit. There are things that the Lord will want us to do, but by our own standard, by our own estimation, we wouldn't want to do it. We would not even want to have anything associated with it. So we're going to ask God today. Say, Lord, let it be your will, not my will, Lord. Lord, show me things that ordinarily I wouldn't do. Show me places where I wouldn't go. Show me people that I will not associate myself with. I have branded those things as unclean. Things I shouldn't have anything to do with it. Lord, I'm asking you today that you will reveal such things to me. Show me jobs that I won't take. Show me opportunities that I will not take advantage of it, because I probably think that nothing is going to come out of it. Thinking that God hasn't approved it. Show me, Lord, things that you have approved, that I am looking at it, that there is nothing in it. Lord, I ask you today that you will show me those things in Jesus' name. Let's pray for 1 minute. Father, we thank you for speaking to us today. Lord, we know definitely that there are things that we are calling unclean in our lives, in our places of work, in our situation, Lord. Lord, we ask you today that you will open our eyes to see those things. Lord, the same way you showed Peter a vision, because you have a plan for the house of Cornelius. Lord, you want the whole family to be saved. Lord, places that we will not want to go. Lord, we yield ourselves, we surrender ourselves to you, Lord, that you will open our eyes to see things, Lord, that you have approved, which we think is not important, which we think is not necessary. Lord, we pray today in the name of Jesus that you will open our eyes to see those things, and you will give us the willingness to follow your plan, to follow your will, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Amen and amen. I want to thank you very much for joining on this prayer meeting. We have come to the end of the prayer meeting. I want you to watch out, because the Lord will lead you to a place where you will find something great. You will think there is nothing there. But I tell you something, by the time you get to the place, oh, you will find something great in the mighty name of Jesus. There are things that the Lord has approved that we think that is common, unholy. The Lord will lead us to those things in the mighty name of Jesus. For those of us who have joined via the Zoom platform, if you want to stay on, that's fine. I just want to give somebody the opportunity to say yes to Jesus. For people who are watching this video later on, I want to invite you to Jesus. I want you to come and participate in supernatural life. I want you to be a partaker of the divine nature. You see, the invitation I'm extending to you is for you to come and experience a supernatural life. Christianity is not an experience. I am inviting you to come and meet God on a personal level. I don't get scared now, because when we talk about meeting God, people think the only time you're going to meet God is when you die. No. Jesus Christ came so that we may have eternal life. And eternal life is knowing God, having a personal revelation of God. And that's what I'm inviting you to today. The way you are going to come into the revelation of God, to know who God is you have to come through Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the way. That is the way that God has made for us to come to Him. He came, He died for our sin, He rose from the dead, and He is now with the Father. So what happened is that He paid the price for your salvation. So He is the one that, you know, when you come and then you accept Him into your life, He will also raise you up onto this supernatural life, so that you have a joint sitting in the heavenly places. So if you want to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and as your Savior, I want you to say these prayers after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I confess that I am a sinner. I repent of my sins today. I believe you died for me so I can have eternal life. I ask you to come into my heart. Be my Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you very much for saying that prayer. You're going to see our email address. I want you to write us, send us a text message. Tell us that you have taken this decision today. You have given your life to Jesus Christ. You have taken the decision, and we're going to send some materials to you that is going to help you grow spiritually. I want you to do one more thing. I want you to find a local church that you can join and be part of them. We have a series of online activities that you can be part of. We have Bible study on Friday. It's online. Today is Tuesday when we do our prayer meeting. I want to invite you to a special session on prayer and fasting from November 1st is a time where we wait on God concerning the year 2019. You know, we have chosen to do it early. We don't want to wait until 2019 before we begin to declare what's going to happen in 2019. That's not the way God do things. He would declare it before it happens. So that's why we have chosen, you know, the first 2 weeks in the month of November to wait on God. He has given us a word for 2019. And that word is, follow me. I will make you a different kind of person. So that's the word of the Lord for 2019. I am inviting you every day. If you can pray, if you can fast, just miss a meal at least. And then join us more importantly, 9 p.m. every day from 1st of November. We will be praying with this word that the Lord has given unto us. I believe, God, that you have been blessed today. If you want to share this prayer video with someone, you are more than welcome to do it. May God himself, the God who makes everything holy and whole, make you holy and whole, put you together, spirit, soul, and body, and keep you fit for the coming of our Master Jesus Christ. The one who called you is completely dependable. If he said it, he will do it. Until I come your way with another edition of the Prayer and Supplication in the Spirit, or the Mirror of the Word, which I'm going to do tomorrow, and then inviting you for our prayer and fasting, God bless you. Have a wonderful evening. Don't forget the word of the Lord that we receive today. Do not call that which the Lord has called clean unclean. What God has approved, don't say that is common. There is nothing in it. I believe God, as you believe his word, as you walk with his word, great things will happen in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you and God bless you.